We can sum up McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich in one word. Crispy. But also juicy and tender. Maybe crispy, juicy, tender. Or one word? Okay, fine. You'll just have to try our crispy chicken sandwich to understand it.
Now get medium crispy golden fluffy fries for free when you buy one of our new crispy chicken sandwiches. Price and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with combo meal. Not available on McDelivery.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Introducing Peacock, the new free streaming service from NBC Universal. It's hit movies, current shows, live sports, trending bits, and timeless hits. And that's why you can't not watch. Peacock, watch for free, upgrade for more. Stream now at peacocktv.com. Law & Order SVU streaming now.
Alabama, Arkansas, I do love my ma and pa, not the way that I love you. Holy moly, me oh my, you're the apple of my eye. Girl, you never loved no one like you. Man, oh man, you're my best friend. I scream and do nothing else. There ain't nothing that I need. Well, hot, heavy pumpkin pie, chocolate candy, Jesus Christ. There ain't nothing please me more than you. I'm home, let me come home. Home is wherever I'm with you. I'm home, let me come home. Home is wherever I'm with you. Yeah.
It never ceases to amaze me how many creative covers there are to our theme music. That's a brand new one. Well, it may not be brand new, but I don't think we've ever played that one before, Sam. Good find on that. Who is that?
His name is Charles Perry. It was really good. I like this one.
He is out of control. I love him. I want to hear him again. So put him in the rotation. KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. You are listening to Home. I'm Dean Sharp, the house whisperer, custom home builder, custom home designer, here with you live like I am every weekend, Saturdays from 6 to 8, Sundays from 9 to 11. Welcome. Welcome to the second hour of our fine program. What are we here to do? I'm here to help, to be an advocate for you as you wrestle with construction on your home, a design mentor for you, very much today, a design mentor for you, and a friend. Because why not? Helping you build yourself a more beautiful home, more beautiful life, and here's the catch, to do it more affordably and more artfully than you had ever imagined. That is our goal. This weekend, I'm taking a two-part series, today and tomorrow, talking about the very tricky scenario of finding your style, finding your own personal style, because finding a style, the intent, the story that we're going to tell for your home, for your remodel, for your new home build, whatever that may be, that is the first and most important step. It is the foundation for everything that goes forward from there. And I've been saying we've been discussing six significant problems that get in the way of finding your style, the most problematic of which, the last one, that most people find themselves in one camp or the other on the style spectrum. There are those who don't see style as being all that important. They think it's sort of vain and frivolous. They don't see what the fuss is all about. That's a group that doesn't understand the practical effects that style has on all of us. And then there's a group that really, really wants to find their style, so much so that there's the risk of taking it to the extreme that it sort of paralyzes you, and you don't know what decision to make because we're taking it so seriously. So my goal here in the next few minutes is to take the pressure off that group and to put a little pressure on the other one. So let's do that. Let's talk about those of you who I think are probably in the majority of our faithful listeners, those who are serious about finding your style and who may be stressed by the idea that, what if I make the wrong decision? So here's the thing. Let's get a healthy understanding of what living in a dream home really means. And I can speak with some authority on this since that's my job, to build dream homes for people. You know, if you're an old coot like me, but hip, if you're hip and old at the same time, which is probably not even a thing that is possible. But anyway, you might remember from the 90s, the movie The Fight Club. Ed Norton, right? Brad Pitt, really intense movie. I really actually liked Fight Club a lot. It is a postmodern nihilistic philosophical rant on the woes of modern society. So Ed Norton's character, there's a place near the beginning of the film where he goes on a rant and he's mocking rampant consumerism as symbolized for him by the IKEA catalog. Okay, it's kind of a funny take on things. But he says one of the most memorable lines of the movie, for me at least, and as a designer, it struck me then and it has just stuck with me. He says this, and he's saying this in all seriousness. He says, "What coffee table defines me as a person?" I love that line, and I'm sharing it with you because I think it symbolizes the difficulty of those of us who take design very seriously. We get caught in this trap. What coffee table defines me as a person? Well, here's the thing. We don't need to go that far. It's impossible. All right. So let me just take the pressure off you. No coffee table defines you as a person. We're just looking to make a good choice that resonates with you. In the setting that you find yourself in. That's it. A good choice that resonates with you in this setting here and now, not once and for all. All right. And so let me underscore this. Tina and I live in a home that we redesigned ourselves from corner to corner, right? Whose interiors are, well, various forms of early 20th century design. That was a very intentional decision on our part. We had long conversations about that, what it means to us, why we love it. I would like to think that our home is an extremely thoughtful home. Most people who walk into it get that impression as well. And so there you go. We've tried to be mindful about all of our choices. And as a result, our home tells a story. I think a really lovely story. But does it tell our whole story? Of course not. Does the fact that we've chosen these expressions for this house structure mean that we couldn't live in any other style of home? Not at all. We're home designers. We love many, many different styles. Love them, okay? All it means to live in it. So you're saying, Dean, that this isn't your dream home? No, of course it's a dream home. It's a dream home because everywhere I turn, this house fits me really, really well. And it fits Tina really, really well. And it pleases us in all of those aspects. So all it means is that this home tells as much of our story as it possibly can. It will never tell the whole story. Because there are parts of me that if you gave me the option, would I set a home like this on a lake? In a forest? Yes, I would. Oh, yes. Yes, I would. Would it be on a cliff in New England above a rocky seashore? Oh, yes, it would. See, that's a different place, too. And there are several other locations where I could imagine living in, quote unquote, my dream home. So you see, it doesn't always have to be. In fact, it never should be somehow this summary of everything all together, period, permanent, that's it, okay? So take the pressure off, okay? Living in a dream home means you've done your best to tell a story that resonates with you and that we're simply getting the most out of this home, telling as much of your story as it possibly can. And it doesn't have to go beyond that. Okay, I hope we are all breathing a collective sigh of relief that you don't have to experience the paralysis of figuring out what coffee table defines you as a person. No. No, no, no. Okay, so just take a rest. Now, for that other person. Yeah, you. I know, you. I'm talking to you. The one who says, why is style even important? Just buy the damn couch, okay? We need to have a talk about a growing understanding of how style actually affects our minds. I'm going to be borrowing a few tidbits from a website that I really love entitled YouReNotSoSmart.com. I love this blog because he goes out of his way to find areas of scientific fact where things that we don't like to think they have an effect on this. Yeah, they do. Yeah, they do. And we have known for well over a century and a half how color and shape and the psychology of identity and symbolism, all, whether you like it or not, has an effect on you. And so since it does, and I'm going to show you some indications of how it does, since it does, design of your new home, of your new remodel, that needs to move near the top of your list because this is going to be something, as Winston Churchill said, in which we shape our buildings, and right after that, they begin to shape us. Okay, more of that when we return. I'm so glad you joined me this morning. So much more to come. You're home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer.
There's no better feeling than getting a great deal, like a hotel room upgrade or a free car wash with every tank of gas. Maybe unlimited chips and salsa with your burrito. And now, as an AT&T wireless customer, you can get an exclusive deal on a super fast internet experience with AT&T Fiber. Get consistently fast speed, even during peak times, and a great deal with AT&T Fiber. Learn more at att.com/fiber offer. Limited availability in select areas based on wired connection to gateway. Restrictions apply.
Why? When you can. Why? When you can. Taste the thrill with Coca-Cola and Six Flags. Save up to 50% on tickets with promo code Coke at sixflags.com.
Is that true, Tim? Is that... Wait, here, grab your mic. Is that... I'm just asking you if that's... If what Janet is telling us is true.
Maybe for her.
Okay.
Because she's singing about it.
It's not true for you? You don't want to lead a glamorous life?
Oh. How about that show?
Oh, my gosh. I've touched a nerve. Oh, no. All right. KFI, Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer, at your service. We are talking about finding your style. It's a tricky subject. But you know what? We're taking it down step by step. A two-part series today and tomorrow. So we're setting up the problems today, hopefully framing the subject best we can. Tomorrow we'll be knocking as many pins down as we can along the way as well. So don't miss tomorrow's show as well because it is the conclusion of what we're beginning today. Also, in just a few moments, we're going to go back to the phones. So let me give you the number. The lines are open yet again. 833-2-ASK-DEAN. 833-2-ASK-DEAN. You can call me about anything. I'm talking finding style today, but we can talk about leaky toilets. We can talk about design questions, construction issues, whatever. Anything having to do with your home, give me a call. Let me see if I can help you out. Okay, as promised, I'm going to put the pressure on those who have a tendency to say, yeah, you know, style, whatever. See it as superfluous, see it as a thing that is sort of frivolous, okay?
Do I take offense? No, I don't take offense. You know, I'm quite secure in my profession of choice and my knowledge of why we do what we do as designers and why style is important. By the way, am I a fashionista? No, I'm not. I'm not one of those. And I think there is a level of kind of pop fashion and pop style that is a little, you know, offensive because it's just simply, it is superficial and superfluous. That's not the kind of style I'm talking about. When I say the word style, by the way, you know what the root of it is? For me, style is just a shortened version of lifestyle. That's what we're really trying to get to when we're designing a custom home. We are trying to understand the flow of someone's life. We're trying to understand lifestyle and how does lifestyle, your lifestyle, how does that symbolically translate into the shapes and structures and colors and textures and experiences architecturally of the place where you live? How does your home adequately and accurately reflect and assist you in your lifestyle? That, for me, is the conversation of style. For those of you who tend to kind of poo-poo it, okay, and I'll share this again, last time, I promise. We shape our buildings, and thereafter they shape us. One of my favorite architectural quotes from a non-architect, Winston Churchill, said that. We shape our buildings, and thereafter they shape us. I don't know exactly what he was processing through at the time when he said that, but he was absolutely right. And the science of human nature and psychology backs it up. Color. Let's just talk about the psychology of color for a moment. Color is the main component of how we experience the world around us. They have a definitive effect on moods, emotions. There's a little debate regarding exactly the implication of certain shades. But researchers, designers, we all agree on the basic tenets. Things like red. Red is a color of power, passion, right? Likely evolutionarily, okay? Anger, right. It's just, you know, that kind of energy. Why? Probably because evolutionary, and this is universal, it's probably because of blood. In fact, we're all pretty well convinced it's blood. Red is the color of our blood. When people get angry, when they exert themselves, our skins are flushed, right, with blood, and so on. So red takes on that quality for us. You know, we even say things like, oh, I got so angry I was seeing red, right? It's passion, it's power, it's arousal, it's exertion, it's all of those things. And there's no separating that. If you're a human being, there's no separating the color red from having that meaning to you and the way that it affects your mood. On the other end of the spectrum, sort of, not color spectrum, but yellow. Yellow is the color of sunlight. Again, evolutionarily, golden yellow sunlight, life, warmth. That's why yellow is the universal color of happiness and creation. That's why we own a yellow Jeep. Happiness. That's all it comes down to. Oh my gosh, look at the time. All right, we're going to go a little bit more into this. And then when we come back, also, we're going to go to the phones. You're home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Your call's up next. KFI, AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app, your home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. We're talking finding your style. It's a tough subject, maybe one that I shouldn't have taken up, but I'm trying. I probably shouldn't have taken up on the day that the Titanic set sail 109 years ago, thinking, you know what? What could go wrong with this topic? No. We're having a good time. We are doing this today as a two-part series this weekend, talking finding your style. It's a big enough subject that it deserves two shows. So today and tomorrow. So for the exciting conclusion of Finding Your Style. Don't miss tomorrow's show from 9 to 11. All right, but we've got more to come here. It's time to go to the phones, as promised. Phil, welcome home.
Got a 1980 ranch-style 2,000-square-foot home that we're looking to redo inside. I'm looking at that plank flooring that you discussed a few weeks ago, and we're trying to decide on colors for both our floor and all our paint. We see gray everything out there. I really like it, but we kind of want to go toward what's coming out, and gray seems to have been around for quite a while now, and we don't want to build something that's kind of obsolete in a year or two. What would you recommend as far as interior paint and the flooring colors?
That is a massive question, Phil. I hope you know that. So it's a question that varies according to the topic we're talking about today, your style and what that means. But I will tell you this. I think at the heart of what you're asking is, what do we do with the largest surfaces? And here is where I might surprise you. In fact, I regularly surprise people when I say this, because everybody expects a designer to throw all sorts of craziness up on the walls and the ceilings and go wild and bold, and that's one of those fears. So I'm going to tell you this. As a general rule, if you were to twist my arm behind my back and say, Dean, sight unseen, tell me the color of my house. Well, this is what I'm going to say. White. I want you to paint your walls white. A warm white, not beige, not cream, not eggy, okay? Just a warm white. Warm meaning slightly towards the warm side of the spectrum as opposed to the cool side. I don't want a blue white in there. And I'll tell you why. A couple of reasons, at least. Number one, every house, all houses need more light inside. And white is the most reflective color that we can paint on the walls. And as a result, white recycles light. That's a term I like to use, recycling light, because what light gets into a room, a white wall and a white ceiling, bounces it around, reflects it off its surface, and we get to reuse that light for as long as possible before it escapes the room. It brightens everything up. Number two, white provides a background for all of the really great stuff. And I just, what I mean by that is, think about any and every museum you've ever walked into. What are the colors on the wall? Well, by and large, white. And there's a very good reason for that. Because it shows off the art. It shows off the stuff that we really want to be looking at. I am a big believer in intensity in contrast. And so, especially if you're putting wood plank flooring through the house, and honestly, I'm not going to tell you what intensity of floor to put, because if we're beachy and we're like light and mapley, or if we're dark, I mean, and brooding like a deep walnut floor, or anything in between, it's all good if it works with the style. But I love the idea of the darker the floor, the lighter the walls should be, so that they really pop and complement each other in richness of contrast. And when it comes to ceilings, we don't paint a ceiling another color, especially if we have lower ceilings. Now, if you've got a 17, 18, 20-foot high ceiling, then fiddle around with a more brooding color up on the ceiling, because it's going to be a point of interest, right? But a darker ceiling or an off-color ceiling in a normal height house, 8-foot, 9-foot ceilings, by throwing that color option darker on the ceiling, what we're doing is we're drawing attention to it, and the ceiling kind of comes down on us. It kind of sits down on us. We don't want that. We want the ceiling to go away. The lower the ceiling, the more we want it to sort of not be an issue. So I would bring white up the walls and white right onto the ceiling. And then when it comes to trims, baseboards, floors, that's when we get into other things. And it's not to say that we can't have feature walls or even an entire room with bold paint color or wallpaper. But where we start, the blank canvas, we start with white. Decorator's White, that's one of our premier colors that we use, of Benjamin Moore. Swiss coffee, those kinds of just slightly on the warm side, pleasant whites, but white nonetheless. There you go. That's the starting point. And everything goes with white, by the way. So, because white is technically not a color, not scientifically. White is all colors of the entire spectrum blended together all at once, and we get white light. So everything goes with white. And so it's a fine starting point, and white will never go out of style. Well, sometimes white cabinets will go out, but white walls in a house and ceiling will never, ever, ever go out of style because it's science. All right, Phil, thanks for the question. When we come back, some closing thoughts for you, just for today, though, on the subject of finding your style, your home, with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer.
Fracture prints your digital photos directly onto glass, making your favorite moments come alive in vivid color. Hand-assembled in the USA, Fracture glass prints are a unique and beautiful way to display and share your favorite moments. Simply upload your photo at fractureme.com, select your size, and your glass print will be shipped to you, ready to hang with just one screw. Use code POD15 to get 15% off your order today. That's code POD15 at fractureme.com.
Buying a home can feel like navigating uncharted waters. Redfin agents can help. They'll answer your questions with honest advice so you know exactly what you're getting into. They'll also help you tour as many homes as you want and show you what it takes to make a winning offer. With a Redfin agent on your side, you can sail straight to your dream home. Local expertise from Redfin. That's real estate done right. Tour subject to property and agent availability. See DRE number 01521930.
Is it Alan or Anna's? I think it's Alan's. Yeah, it could be. Those are just more rare. Oh, Tina and I are just having a hummingbird debate. Hey, KFI, AM 640, Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer, welcome home. Thanks for joining our hummingbird conversation. Actually, not what we're talking about today at all. I'm talking about finding your style. Finding your style. It is a tricky subject. That's why I'm taking 2 days, 2 days to do it. Today, we've laid the groundwork by introducing the troubles, the problems, the tendencies of the two camps when it comes to style, the two main camps, those who are over-worried about style, those who have a tendency to ignore it and shouldn't. And so starting tomorrow, you're not going to want to miss tomorrow's show because we're going to creep into, okay, so what are the steps that we're actually going to take to discover your style? The weight of this, of course, the frustrating point for me is the weight of this is primarily upon you. I can't give you your style. I can't tell you what your style is. I can help you find it. I can hint at it. I can amplify it, but I can't make that decision for you. This is the hard work that you're going to have to accomplish for yourself. But I can tell you all the reasons why it's right and good and noble to do it. So we talked about the psychology of color. Now, you know, I'm in the thumbscrew section of the show where I'm taking those of you who have a tendency to kind of poo-poo style as a vain or superfluous, and just indicating that, no, in fact, the things around us, whether you like it or not, have a profound effect upon us. So we talked a little about the psychology of color, color being something that affects our mood, our thinking, so on. I gave you a few examples, red, yellow. There are others there as well. Maybe we'll post this list because people seem to really get into the psych. Here, I'll give you one more. Black. How about black? Which technically also is not a color, but black. It's power, but its power doesn't come from the same place that red comes from. Red comes from this energetic kind of power, right? You know what? Black is the power of mystery and the unknown. Why? Scientifically, because black is not a color. It is the absence of color. Black reflects nothing back. Black gives you nothing. It takes and it gives you nothing in return. So when somebody is draped in black, there's a certain mystery there, right? The mystery is intriguing. That gives them power because apparently they know something you don't know. There's a depth to it. And black also is a sharp show of contrast. So there you go. Just another example, and there are endless examples of the psychology of color. Let's talk really quickly about shape. Shape is the same thing. Shapes have a definitive effect on mood and emotion. Squares and rectangles, they're all about discipline, strength, courage. Tina, who graduated from the Harvard Law of Art School's Art Center out in Pasadena with a degree in graphic design and advertising, one of the very first things that they discussed in fonts, right, for print ads, is the shape of a font and the way that it projects what it does. Banks use very boxy, square kind of fonts. Why? Because banks want you to feel secure. Your money is safe here, okay? It is stable. Not many people really attracted to a bank with a real scripty font, because somewhere in the back of your head, you're like, I don't know about those guys. They seem a little too whimsical with my money. I don't want that whole whoop-a-hoo. Hey, bring your money over here. Woohoo! Look at the fun we're having. No. I just want a vault, all right? Now, if you're going for an investment brokerage, okay, then likely you're going to see angles, triangles, because triangles are about energy. Dynamic thing, because you want your money to grow. You're like, go out there, get that done. All right. Triangles are associated with motion and direction. When a triangle is upright, okay, it's all about balance and focus. If you flip a triangle upside down with the point down, it's about risk. It's like a sword of Damocles waiting to fall. And that is why, FYI, yield signs at the on-ramps of freeways are upside-down triangles with red, energy, passion, danger, a red border, the word yield right in the middle, upside-down triangle. In other words, something that sparks in the back of your brain. Whoa, something could happen. Something could happen if we're not aware. That's exactly why yield signs are upside-down triangles. So, circles, ovals, timelessness, because they don't have a beginning or an end, you know, sun, moon, stars, orbits, that kind of thing, natural shapes. All right, one last thing I want to get in today to kind of prove this point. The psychology of identity. You've heard the saying that clothes make the man or dress for success, right? Well, it's true. It's true. Here is a lab coat experiment, and here's the next thing you're going to share at the next party that you go to post-COVID, okay? The lab coat experiment. This was published a couple of years ago in the Journal of Experimental Social Psychology. A group of researchers took several groups of people, just normal old folk, okay? A nice broad spectrum of the population. And they did attention to detail tests, tests requiring attention to detail. And so everybody was given the test, and, you know, the scores were the scores. Then they took part of that group, gave them another attention to detail test, but before doing so, dressed them in white lab coats, told them, we want you to wear these white scientific lab coats. That group of people retook their tests, not the same test, but, you know, took another attention, scored universally higher in attention to detail. Why? Because they were wearing a lab coat, because they identified with the precision of scientific thinking. And you're like, okay, are you sure? Okay, that was the question they asked. Are we sure? So here's another thing. They took another group of people, put them in the white lab coats, but this time told that group, these are painter's smocks. They didn't tell them that they were doctor's lab coats. They told them that they were painter's smocks. And that group scored the same as they did before, as if they were dressed in just their street clothes. So you see, the symbolism of identity. This whole study was called enclothed cognition. It simply means this, everybody. The visual world around us, it affects us. Design matters most. And since design starts with a style intention, style lays at the foundation of everything we're trying to do with our homes. Okay, we've laid the groundwork. I hope I've got your attention. I hope I've calmed you if you panic with style and excited you if in the past you have dismissed it. That's part one. Part two, tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock, we're going to start finding ways, handing you practical ways to discover your style. We'll do it then. Handle on the Laws up next. I'm out of here. Whatever your plan is for the day, be intentional. Get out there. Build yourself a beautiful life. We'll see you tomorrow morning.
This is Peacock.
I love it!
It's streaming your favorite shows, movies, live sports, breaking news, exclusive originals. It's The Office.
That's what she said.
Chrisley Knows Best.
It's gonna be Todd's Way or the Highway.
And Peacock original shows like Punky Brewster.
Holy mackinoli.
So whether you're in the mood for every live WWE pay-per-view or every episode of Law & Order SVU, Peacock's got you covered. Peacock, watch for free, upgrade for more. Stream now at PeacockTV.com.
A lot goes into taking care of your property. You need equipment with more reliability, durability, and versatility built in. Like number one selling Kubota BX and L-Series compact tractors, Z-Series mowers that deliver a quality cut, and Sidekick utility vehicles where durability meets speed. Visit your local Kubota dealer for a demo today.
Visit GoKubota.com for a dealer near you.